Welcome YouTube. This video is for the people that play Warhammer Fantasy. For the experienced players, you might as well just turn it off. For those that are novices, then continue to view. What is this video about? Well, it's about movement trays. Movement trays. I'm not sure if Games Workshop still sells these, but these are the plastic ones. There was like a bunch of them for 10 bucks. Use these in 5th and in 6th edition, back when a rank was 4 models wide. Now with the advent of 7th edition, models are now, to get a rank, you need 5 wide. Well, a lot of these are no longer that useful. So what do people do? I've seen cardboard, I've seen metal, I've seen movement trays with edges, no edges. Okay, so how do I make my movement trays? Well, we'll get to that in a second. These right here are my homemade trays. You can see these are all 100, that's 5 20 millimeter guys, by 120, which is 6 deep. I use these guys when I had my Skaven army for my clan rats. Then next, I got a 6 foot, I'm sorry, this right here, it says Plague Priest on it. I used to run them guys 6 wide and up to 4 deep. As you can see, I have all different sizes. This was Rat Ogres, 4 Rat Ogres. That one's a little beat up. So, what do I do? Well, I use this stuff right here. This is by Midwest. This is a balsa wood. This is actually called Baltic Birch. It is 3 millimeters thick. And this piece is 6x12. You can get this in all different kinds of sizes. I like this because the stuff is at 3 millimeters, is not quite an eighth of an inch because it's 25 millimeters in an inch, but it's close to it. Is this stuff strong? Well, let me show you. See this custom Bretonian lance formation one I made? Look, no flexing, you don't have to worry about it breaking. And that, this one is set up, whoops, guy just fell over and one fell off. But that holds 12 knights. And then this is one I made before Games Workshop came out with bases for the chariots. This one works okay, a little big, but hey, it works nonetheless. So, I use this birch. This was like $1.50, and then for edging, I use these rods. They're like 2 foot long. And these are 1/8 inch squares. That's just what I like to use, 1/8 inch. And those are like 29 cents each. Okay, for my project that I'm going to work on, I'm going to make a movement tray that is for 5 dragon princes. Actually, it's going to be 6 wide because we're going to put a hero in there. So as you can see, there'll be 6. Notice there is a gap, but by the time you add the edging to both sides, the gap is, it takes up almost the whole entire 6-inch wide. As you can see, there's not much space. I would also put one strip of the wood here, not on the back, it's not needed. I just feel like 3 sides. And this way, it would be 6 wide. Okay, the kinds of glue, all you need for this, to do these kind of projects, is razor blade knife, tape measure. If your tape measure has millimeters, then that would greatly help you in this. I cut the wood, the big pieces. You can use any kind of saw, but I can have a little chop saw or miter saw out in the garage. It just burns through this stuff. And that's how I make these trays. The kind of glue, I just use my general Gelfort 9 hobby glue. You can use Elmer's glue, you can use wood glue, and it doesn't take that long to adhere. It usually adheres pretty well because the wood is porous. And once you've got it done, you can spray paint it. I'm sorry, primer it. And the thing I like about this is with these 1/8 inch rods, You can actually add, if you wanted to, when you go to base your stuff, there's actually enough area to actually base, put small rocks. So that's basically it. I'm not gonna cut this one out at this moment, but you guys get the gist of this video. Anyways, if you have any questions, post it on YouTube. But these movement trays are easy to make. As you can see, once I make this one, I'll still have approximately, not quite 10 inches, even though this is 12 inches, because this is, I'm going to use up 50 millimeters, which is right at 2 inches plus an eighth of an inch. So I'm just going to be on the short side. I will probably build probably a 10 wide or 12 wide one for the high elk archers, where I can put them on a hill too deep. But besides that, yeah, that was my three-legged kitty. She's very curious. Anyways, hope this helps some people out. Like I said, if you have any questions or anything, just post. I'll be glad to help you if I can. And like I said, easy to make, and they're not expensive at all.